Hi viewers, today we are going to discuss about a topic called The Tiger King from Vista's book 12th Standard CBSE English. About the author, this story was written by Ramaswamy Iyer Krishnamurthy. His pen name was Kalki. He was a famous Tamil writer, journalist, poet, critic and Indian independence activist. He wrote 120 short stories, 10 novelettes, 5 novels, 3 historical romances, editorial and political writings, and hundreds of film and music reviews. An overview of this lesson. The theme of this lesson is men in power, ruthless towards wildlife. That means the people, those who are in power, they were very cruel towards wildlife. Death is inevitable. Inevitable means that something which is not avoidable. The Maharaja of Pratibandhapuram is the hero of this story. He may be identified as Sir Jilani Jung Jung Bahadur. In this story, the author wanted to tell us that how he came to be known as Tiger King. This story is related to the death of the king. When Jilani Jung Jung Bahadur was born, the astrologers revealed that the prince would be killed or died by the tiger. At that moment, a great miracle took place. The 10 days old prince talked with the wise prophets. The boy asked about the mystery of his death. At the time, he was only 10 days old. Astrologers declared that the prince was born in the hour of the bull. Bull is nothing but a kind of star. The bull and the tiger are enemies. Therefore, death comes to him in the form of tiger. Astrologers declared that he will die due to tiger because he was born in the hour of bull. So, bull and tiger are enemies. So, definitely he will be killed by the tiger. The prince grew taller and stronger day by day. When he was 20, the kingdom came into his hands. He became the king when at the age of 20. He started killing tigers in the Pratibandhapuram forest. The Maharaja was thrilled when he killed first tiger. He sent the dead body to the state astrologer. But the state astrologer said that he may kill 99, but he should be very careful with the 100th tiger. By that time onwards, the state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the king. That means only king should kill the tiger. A high-ranking British officer wished to hunt tigers in Pratibandhapuram. The Maharaja and the Diwan held some discussions over this issue. At last, they denied. They did not give permission for the British officer to kill tigers in Pratibandhapuram. They sent 50 rings from British Company of Jewelers in Calcutta to British lady to avoid the risk of danger from British officer. She accepted all rings and it cost 3 lakh rupees. He escaped from danger. Within 10 years, the Maharaja killed 70 tigers. Soon, the population of tiger reduced in the kingdom. He decided to marry a girl in the royal family of a state with a large tiger population. He ordered Diwan to search for a girl. His plan is to kill as many as tigers in others' kingdom also. That's why he decided to marry a girl. Maharaja Jilani Jung Jung Bahadur killed 5 or 6 tigers when he visited his father-in-law's house. Now he reached to 99 figure. By this time, the tiger farms had run dry even his father-in-law's kingdom. He had to be very careful with the 100th tiger. He knew that he should be very careful because in father-in-law's kingdom also the population of tiger is reduced. He did not find any tiger to kill. He sank in gloom. He sank in gloom means he was very, 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 very sad in this issue. But soon he heard that sheep began to disappear from a hillside village. Maharaja thought it was the work of tiger and announced a 3-year exemption from all taxes for that village. One day he heard that most of the sheep were disappearing in the hillside village. Then he thought that it was the work done by the tiger. So in that happy mood, he announced a 3-year exemption from all taxes for that particular village people. But the tiger was not found easily. By this, one day Maharaja's rage increased and doubled the land tax. Rage means anger. To control his anger, Diwan went to People's Park in Madras and he brought one tiger secretly and he pushed it down to the ground from his car in the forest. On the following day, the king took careful aim at the beast. He ordered the remaining hunters to bring the dead body of the tiger to the kingdom. But unfortunately, the tiger was not dead. It was fell down due to the sound. Hunters only killed the 100th tiger without informing to the Maharaja. By this, we understood that Maharaja did not kill the 100th tiger, but he thought that it was died due to his powerful aim. A few days later, Maharaja gifted a wooden tiger to his son's third birthday. One day, while playing with wooden tiger, one of the slivers pierced into the Maharaja's right hand. Slivers means one of the part from wooden tiger. It was pierced. That means it entered into his Maharaja's right hand. Due to that, his right hand was infected. 3 famous surgeons were called and they treated to Maharaja and they were called from Madras. They failed to cure that infection and they came out from the operation theater and they announced that the operation was successful but the Maharaja is dead. So at last the 100th tiger took revenge upon the king. At last our tiger king was died due to wooden tiger.